I go back to my guys, and everybody says, we're not playing when it's cold. We ain't playing when it's cold.
Yeah. Oh, that's fine.
Well, I get kind of
excited. Hi, Merry Christmas.
Yes. But she's going to call me in January.
This is Marilyn Monroe.
You can go on, but no.
Good to see you. Doug, how are you?
What's she saying?
Happy holidays, Marilyn.
Happy holidays,
Jeremy. You got a beautiful
city. Yeah, well, in Belleville, there's that, this is what she said. But if she supports it, then there's no question. She doesn't know what she's talking about.
I wish it was still open. I tried. I wouldn't say.
Good, yourself?
Worthy.
The ice cream lady. Three flavors. Pumpkin was different. It was good.
We like to get you.
No.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah. What are you looking at?
What are you looking at?
Okay.
You in there, then?
The coffee.
I was gonna say I'm here pink, but I don't know what she is. I just
whatever you do. Hi there, Doug.
Here's the other salmon.
Doug, would you like to hear my
we have another poem?
New Elvis Christmas poem.
I heard it the other night, but I'll hear it again because I got a camera now.
Okay. This is called Elvis Christmas Carol. This is an original take on a holiday classic. So here goes.
Can you carry this again?
'Twas the night before Christmas, and all was jolly. The kids were at Grandma's house, and my wife and I were feeling naughty. As I glanced out the window at the swirling snow, I saw Elvis P. Claus and eight tiny rockets and a rockin' sleigh full of mistletoe, you know. I went about my business, kissing and hugging my wife under the tree when Elvis P. Claus crashed down the chimney. He was dressed all in leather from his head to his foot. He looked like a horny old hound dog as he shook. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work. He filled all the stockings with poutine and cheeseburgers and stuff. I don't really think he was a real Santa. I'd like to call his bluff. What happened next is hard to believe, Doug. He had a bouquet of roses for my wife up his sleeve. He was really becoming my ultimate Christmas pet peeve. Just then, he did something that made me change my mind. He serenaded us all with Blue Christmas, and we had a merry old time. In a flash, he was gone, but in the words of Elvis, it's Christmas time, pretty baby, and that can't be wrong. So good night to all, and so long. Thank you very much. And have yourself a cool Yule holiday this year. God bless you all. I love you. And hi to Missy. Aloha in Vegas. Having a Christmas vacation. I hope you win the jackpot, baby.
She's in Vegas? This is what's left of the massive buffet dinner.
Now, Douglas, if I may take a moment of your time, what does Christmas mean to you?
Where would I start? It means coming to this party every year.
Yes.
It means seeing you guys in the parade every year.
You're a wonderful person. Your whole family is, and we're just honored to know you. And thoughts and prayers are with you and your lovely wife, Carolyn. And
yes, I always know. And
Jocelyn and your mom and Bruce and everybody and you mean a lot to us and it's just great knowing you and I hope you have a wonderful merriest Christmas and a happy and healthy 2009.
Same to you.
My bride to be.
He was just talking about you.
Oh, come on. She's a visual lover.
No, I was going to say now Jocelyn. She's too young.
I like all the
you're
women.
Awake now.
I like all the women of any age. 18 to 80.
Good man. I love you. Chocolate
or a little pumpkin or both?
So what happens when we had coupons and we never used them? Nothing? No
here,
good now.
I put it back so like everybody takes it.
That's why you get deeper, it gets still hard.
Yep.
Sing along.
out and do something.
This is the amazing Bedford. She's got an incredible voice.
Hi, Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Would you be able to favor us with this arm before you go?
I'd love to, but I don't have to.
Okay, great.
I guess I better get out of my way. I'm going to put my name on this. If I win, I want the money to go or the
okay.
Everyone, give yourselves a hand. I'm sorry I haven't left the table, but as it is customary for me, I end up talking before I eat. So, anyway, I want to take this opportunity to introduce some people that I just saw or where they've come in not too long ago, one of which, I don't know where he just disappeared to, Counselor Gardner Thompson from the city of Belleville. Thanks for coming, Gardner. Merry Christmas. Would you like to say a few words?
No.
I know you're never lost for words. I'll give you the mic. Just a minute. Come here.
Just want to wish and thank these group here and their parents for putting on, and everybody else has been involved with this group tonight and party tonight. These guys do an awful lot for the community, so does our parents. So I want to wish you all a very, very Merry Christmas and enjoy the evening, because this is their night. They need the celebration. So congratulations.
Let's play. You want to do some karaoke, Gardner?
No!
You can rock on some.
I'm not a very good karaoke.
That's not what your wife said. She said she was so beautiful in the shower. Is that true? Merry Christmas, man.
That's a good one. Sorry about that. Merry Christmas. Don't pull.
It's in your hair. Oh,
I'm falling apart, kids. Merry Christmas. Come on in. You can sit on my lap. I got a little something for you.
Oh, I'm gonna get my dog. I'm gonna get my dog.
No.
Come on, be in the foreground, Santa.
Hi, Santa, how are you? Is it the warm gift from the North Pole?
We're going to take a snap picture. We got to do it real soon.
There you go.
I'll be real quick. I got to get a...
Get up here!
Just pull.
Okay.